Hi, Amardeep this side. You're watching Tech Bank. So in this video, we are going to solve a pretty irritating or sometimes it's pretty frustrating for some people which makes apps on Google Play Store and they put tremendous amount of hard work and then they put their app on Play Store and suddenly at some point of time their app got rejected or some update got rejected, something like that. And there is some mail like this and I know how are you feeling. If you have got this same error, so this was the same error which I have got around 1 month ago. So this was my update and I was having my Play Store app called College Tutor for simple basic study app and for downloading notes and videos for free. So if you are lucky, then it will be like this, that your previous update will be there and the further update which you have made will not be live on Play Store. But if you are unlucky like me, that so on Play Store my app was not getting searched, even my previous version also, I don't know why. So they have banned me for inappropriate ads policy. So in this video I will be covering this policy also and one more policy problem which I got before this type of ban. So let me read out to you that my app is not compliant with one or more developer policies program and see for more information like that. And they have given the pretty basic and general, always Google will give you an error and give you a pretty general message that you will not get a hang of it, that what it actually says and what is the actual problem. So here I figured it out after 2-3 days, but it took me some while for that, even working in this sector from around 2 years. So it was inappropriate ads policy and they have even given me the image also this time, so that was pretty good by them that they have given me image. And in this image they shown me that the ads which are coming on my app was related to some gaming or some money related gaming. So that's why my age content rating was 3 plus on Play Store. So they said that for 3 plus years of age, these ads are not compliant with their policy for 3 plus age children. So that was pretty good. I think that reason was also good. And I don't know why they banned me now, because it was there from around 1 year or ago. So mostly I think they pick app updates randomly. So if you update your app, so there is no clear procedure that every update will go through a review or something like that. They make automatic review also. Some bots also check the basic things of the app. So it's not sure that if you update and there is some policy infringement in your content in your update, so it will always get caught on the update. But always remember that on the subsequent update that you will make, that error can create a huge problem for you on the other update that you want to do after some time. So for being on the safer side, I choose always to update less and less and only update the app only when it is pretty much required. There are two things after getting this type of app status rejected or something like that. So if you think that error, the message shown by them that why their app is banned is wrong and you think it's done by mistake, then you can directly go to contact our support team and give some messages, support team, and appeal a app suspension. So you can give your name and basic email and your app package will be pre-filled. You can give some images that why you are saying that it's by mistake and state your problem that why you think it's done by mistake. But most of the time I think if they are rejected your app, then most probably you will need to change that thing that is creating the error, and it's most probably it's not by mistake. For sure, for this issue that app is incorrectly rated or some in-app experience was problem. So what you can directly do is that this ad which is there on my app, I need to ban this ad or I need to remove Google Ads altogether. So two things are there. I will show you. You need to go to your Google AdMob section and log in with the account which you are using to show the ads on your app, and go to blocking controls tab, and in this one you can directly go to ad content rating and just select the general version, because if your app is of 3 plus, then I will suggest you to use general audience. And if your app is under parental guidance or 7 plus, and then teens 12 plus, and then mature audience is 18 plus or 16 plus, you can say, then you can select on the basis of that. But if you select general, or parental guidance or teens, then it will show you the message that impressions will go down and match rate will not go up. But so match rate is that number of times your page is opened, some 100 requests is going for the getting the ad, but minus 13% of the time means that 13 page views will not get that ad on that page, even on the teens. And when you go to general audience, so only ads which are compliant with every age group will show up on your application. So that will create a huge downside in your revenue. Your app will be back, but there will be a huge downside in your revenue. So if you want to go this way, then you can directly go to a general audience and then click save, and it will not show that app again. And then you can go to Google Play Console and you can just update anything of your choice and just make a small update like this, press enter or some dot you can remove and hit save, and it will create a new request for your app to review again. And as you have blocked the mature audience content, so that gaming ad or some ad which are coming on your app will not be shown, and your app will be back again on the Play Store. So that is a pretty basic method, but it will create a huge downside on your revenue. So the other method I will be showing you is that you can directly go to blocking controls and then manage sensitive categories, and then you can block the categories which are showing up there. So like this one, and social casino games are blocked on my channel, and gambling and betting is also blocked on my channel. So these types of ad will not come on my video. And after blocking the certain categories, you can go to Play Store and make an update in your description and hit save. So that will also make your app published again, and there will be a little bit less hit on your revenue, because only certain types of gambling ads or some casino games app ads will not come on your app. So here also there is a downside, simple. So I got to know some absolute trick that other apps and big apps are using, that even with the 3 plus category also, they are showing these types of ad and they are getting away with it. Just go to App Content tab in your Google Play console and your selected app, and then you can go to content rating. What I have done is I have selected the questionnaire in the way I am myself saying that in my app there will be some gaming methods used. Even though my app is of downloading notes and videos only, then also in questionnaire I am saying that there will be some sense of gaming into it, because the ads of gamings are coming on my app and I don't want to ban them. I still want to show them because I want to create a better revenue. So what you can do is go to content rating, and then you can click manage, and you can see that my new rating is now with a mature rating in Australia, all ages in Brazil and North America, everyone. So for gaming and gambling types of thing, it is banned in South Korea and Europe, it's 3 plus, and Germany all ages, and rest of the world 3 plus. So I wanted this kind of thing only, because I don't want to have a 16 plus rating or 12 plus rating on my app. So that's why this is good. You can just go to start new questionnaire, where you can mention your email address from where you are getting the updates, and then select the game category. It is necessary for that. And after selecting the game category, you can have like violence no, fear no, sexuality no, but on simulated gambling you have to click yes, because you want to show that types of ad. For you, the different types of ads can be there. So for me, these types of ad was there. So I am selecting the questionnaire like that only. If you are getting some different types of ad, then you can select the questionnaire on based of that. So if you are getting these types of ad, then you have to click yes, and then have that which type of activity is there. So you can go by that way. For me, it was for the game. I have clicked yes, and playable bingo games. No, there is no playable game bingo games, playable games that are not, but just I am showing that, but they cannot play the game on my app. Then after answering these questions, so what I can do is click save. After clicking save, then you can submit your questionnaire, and after submitting your questionnaire, it will automatically create a new review for your app, and it will hopefully get accepted and back on the Play Store. So that's it guys, that's how inappropriate ads policy problem is fixed. And there is one more problem which was there on my app after this review, that there was a issue with my full description. So this time this error was because that I have created that changes in description, and after blocking these ads I submitted a new review, but just because that error was not gone, because my that ad was still showing, then they rejected my app saying that we found that issue in full description, but actually the error was not in description that I have changed on the update, but was the error on the previous history of my rejection status, and because of that they rejected my app. So quite intelligently they have said it in one line, that we identify risk of abuse including but not limited to items such as previous violation history. This is main word for that your previous violation history says that they cannot update your app right now. So that was an extra tip for you, and I thought I need to share it with you because I got that error again. So if you are having any problem doing these things and there is some questions in your mind or how to do it, you can directly comment your error or the problem which you are facing right here in the comment section. I will happy to help you. And if this video helps you in some way or the other, please subscribe to my channel. I make these types of hacky videos regularly. Thank you.